Hello and welcome to this Quick Tip Tuesday. Today's topic is going to be PayPal invoicing. I personally like to use PayPal invoicing for my transcription services and think it works really well as a solopreneur. I find that it's quick and easy to use, the fees are rather minimal, and also I like that even if my client does not have a PayPal account, they can pay the PayPal invoice using a debit or credit card. I'm going to walk you through PayPal invoicing and point out some of the newer features that have recently been added. And this will be via some screenshots to avoid showing you anything in my account that is private or confidential. Let's get started. You're going to want to start off at paypal.com, where you would either log in or sign up for a new account. When you have clicked on log in, here you will enter your email and password and then click log in. Once you've logged into your account, here you're brought to your summary page where it shows you your balance and it also gives you some recent transactions. Up at the top near the center, click on where it says send and request. Next, we come to this screen, and to create an invoice, we want to click on the second to the last option, Create and Manage Invoices. Click on that. Now we come into the Managing Invoices part of PayPal. Up at the top, you'll notice the big blue bar. Hope you like our new look. Now try our new features. Let's click on that now so you can see the list of the new features that are in PayPal invoicing. Here you see the list of the new features within PayPal invoicing. They include choose from three new templates, accept partial payments and deposits, record cash and check payments, send a copy of the invoice to one or more people, share an invoice link with your customer, save a PDF of the invoice, and see more detailed invoice history. I personally like that I can now send a copy of the invoice to one or more people. All right, now let's go ahead and click on Create New Invoice, the small blue box towards the right of your screen. Here is the entire invoice. Looks pretty sharp, has lots of features, but unfortunately it probably looks quite small on your screen. So I'm going to go ahead and cover the top half and the bottom half separately with all its features. Here we are looking at the top half of an invoice. As you can probably notice, on the left-hand side is my business icon, and then underneath that, if I clicked on the arrow, you would see my business information. Just above that where it says My Templates, this is my disclaimer template where I have my disclaimer for work. You can create several templates for different types of invoices that you might be sending. Going over to the right, every invoice has a number and a date. You can also have a reference number and a due date. Below that is a bill to, and you would enter in an email address or the person. What's nice about PayPal is it does save that information for you, so you can click on the address book and select from any number of saved emails, and you can also now add another person to receive the bill, which is really a nice feature. Before, you had to kind of do a little bit of deleting and adding in order to get a second person a copy of that invoice. Right below that is some features that you can customize. Here you can choose whether it's quantity, hours billed, or amount only. The next thing that you can customize is add or remove details such as tax, a detailed description, item discount, date, invoice discount, shipping and handling, or a custom amount. You can also have some advanced tax options. The third thing on the customized bar is the currency. You can choose from several different currencies in the drop-down box. Now we're going to quickly look at the bottom half of the invoice. And again, this is going to look a little different depending on how you customized your own invoice. Here I've got the description, a detailed description, amount, price, and amount, and it will give the total, and as it says USD, I bill in US currency. You can also add a note to your recipient, terms and conditions, and then you can click on to allow partial payment, which is again a newer feature, as well as you can attach a file, add a memo to yourself, you can preview, then you can also send the invoice, and there's more options available. Here in this screenshot, I just wanted to quickly point out the types of files that you can send or attach to your invoice, and then the file size limit, which is 4 megabytes. So that was just a quick rundown of PayPal invoicing. I personally do like to use the PayPal invoicing for my transcription services, and as a solopreneur, I find that those invoices are easy to use, the fees are minimal, and if I have a client that does not have a PayPal account, they can still pay the invoice using a debit or credit card. I hope that you found this video useful. If so, please click on the like button in YouTube. You can also, in YouTube, subscribe to this channel or over on my blog at bombtranscriptionservices.com, you can subscribe for blog updates. If you have any suggestions for tips you'd like me to cover in upcoming videos, please do leave a comment below this video. If you're looking for transcription services, you can find the contact information over on my website, PhamTranscriptionServices.com. That's PHAM Transcription Services with an S.com. Thanks for watching and hope to see you next week.